What are you doing?
I was just gonna back up the trailer.
Oh, mind if I watch?
Okay.
Okay.
What? How did you...
Did you check your mirrors? Don't hit anything. Everybody's watching. You check your brake lights, right? You put the tailgate up. You're always gonna look behind you. You know left is right, right, and right is left. Unless it's Tuesday. Do you know how to do this? Do you know how to drive? Do you know...
No! Welcome to Evention. I'm your host, Jimmy Schramm, with my husband, Dom. And we are wondering, do you suffer from T.R.A.?
Trailer reversing anxiety.
It's pretty obvious that I do. So today, Dom's going to give you guys some tips on how to make reversing your trailer a little bit less stressful.
So trailer reversing doesn't have to be a nightmare. The best thing you should do is get familiar with your trailer. Try not to wait until you've got to put it in a tight spot at the show to practice your reversing skills. Instead, if you've got some time, get out in the field in a big safe area and get to know how to reverse your trailer. With that being said, now I'm going to teach you the secret. Okay guys, so now it's time to teach you the secret. My mum actually taught me this. Hi mum. All right, let's look at the steering wheel. If we imagine that our trailer, our horse trailer, goes from the top of the steering wheel to the bottom, the front of the horse trailer being at the top, the back of the horse trailer being at the bottom. Now we place our hand at the bottom of the steering wheel, the back of the trailer. If we want the back of the trailer to go to our left, then our hand turns left. If we want the back of our trailer to go that way, to the right, hand goes right. So, if you just use that simple idea, you'll be turning the wheel around and around, but the idea remains the same. If your hand is at the bottom and you want the trailer to go left, you want it to go right, hand right. It's as easy as that, supposedly. So, some other things to remember when you're backing the trailer. First of all, is if you have a short bed truck or ute, you gotta be careful if you're turning it tight that the top of the gooseneck doesn't come and bust through your back window. That's one thing. The second thing is that we're turning, we're looking back, and as we swing the truck around, don't forget that the front corner of the truck is going to move out to the side. You don't want to accidentally nudge someone's expensive four-wheel drive as you're backing in. So there's a couple of things to keep remembering. The last thing is that too, the longer the trailer that you're backing, the longer it takes for what you do at the steering wheel to reach the back of the trailer. Okay, so if you're backing a little two-horse bumper pull, or your movements are going to catch up with it pretty quickly. You're backing a big seven-horse trailer, it's going to take a little bit longer. Some common mistakes: getting impatient when you're actually reversing. So people, you'll see them, they'll be going wax on, wax off, and the trailer is just basically snaking along until they end up getting jackknifed and they have to drive forward. Be patient, all right? Make small corrections and just slowly back up and wait for the trailer to catch up with what you're doing, all right? So we're gonna go ahead and give this a try. I'll give you a demonstration. Now, I am by no means a trailer reversing expert, but I do know how to get it in there. You just gotta be patient, all right? So, all right, here's my rule. There's my trailer, hand at the back of the trailer. We're gonna back it in to the right to get it into this tight space. So, which way am I going to turn it? Right, you guessed it, to the right, okay? And we're just going to ease back here. I'm going to check it. Oh, no, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to hit anything. And then when I want it to straighten up again, I'm going to turn it back to the left, all right, to straighten the trailer back up. All right, so I'm going to turn it left. I'm going to hold it, wait for the trailer to catch up. And now we're just going to ease it back now. Perfect. All right, and so now I'm pretty straight. I'm just gonna keep going backwards and I'm in. So don't forget that rule. Also, remember that the longer the trailer is, the longer it's gonna take for what you do to catch up at the back. That's probably the biggest mistake that I see people do. Don't be afraid to get a couple of helpers out to watch the front of the truck as well as the back of the trailer. It's a lot less embarrassing to have someone help you in than it is to sideswipe someone's trailer. So don't be afraid to get someone to give you a hand, or if you're not comfortable doing it, get someone to come and give you a hand. Get a guy to jump in or a girl to jump in, whoever knows how to do it, and they can do it for you. I still recommend at home, you gotta give it a try and you gotta really learn how to do it, because you may get stuck in a tight spot and you have no one to help you. It's important to know how to reverse your trailer and get it into a tight space. Okay, so that leads us on to our Evention tip of the day. Okay, now for my Evention tip of the day. No more backwards and forwardsing trying to get the truck straight. Find the middle of your bed of your truck on your tailgate and line it up with your tow ball and put a piece of tape here. Now, when you're going to hook the trailer up, look in your rear vision mirror and just line up the tape with the hitch of the trailer and you'll be straight every single time. Now, also too, guys, don't forget, when you're unhitching the trailer, always leave the tailgate down. No one wants to be that person that drives around with a tailgate with a big ding in it like this. So, best of luck with your trailer reversing endeavors. Remember, practice makes perfect. Have a good one. Don't mess up. Everybody's watching.